Last post, I've mentioned my ghillie suit, what I made. So I've had a couple of PMs of the lads asking how I made them or how I made it. So I thought I'd just do a quick demo. I don't know how many years I've got old combats lying around that never get used or full of holes. Well, this is what I do with mine. Basically, I have an old pair of combats here. And as you can see, I'm just cutting them into strips. I got a concealment jacket, which basically, I'll show you outside. So basically this is a concealment jacket. I got it off Sai Zini. It already got some scrim on it, and it's got, as you can see, a few patches here and there. So I'm just going to do some adaptions to it, and we'll see what the finished bit's like. So like I say, if you get any old combats, different chuck them. It'll come in handy for something. Right lads, so like I say, I'm cutting them into strips. I've got a section of short ones and a section of longer ones. You don't want them all the same size. Doesn't make any difference which way you cut them. Really all you're doing with a ghillie suit is just breaking up the shape of your body. So just mash it all together. Once I've cut the rest of this, we'll come back and I'll show you what we're doing with the rest of the ghillie suit just to fill it out. I've cut the strips out of the old pair of combat trousers, and as you can see on the, that's where the combat material is, but on the inside it's like a whitey colour. So what I've done, I've got some green spray paint and I've got some black spray paint, and I'm putting a very light dusting just to take the whiteness off. Now it might work, it might not work, but yeah, you don't, you know, I'll find out unless you try, and we'll see how it turns out. I've sprayed it with the paint, and if I step back you can probably see the difference it's made. So hopefully that'll just soak in the material and work nicely on the back of the ghillie suit. Right guys, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to start adding these strips to the ghillie suit. What I do, just snip the ends, and then when you come out of the ghillie suit, basically where you've snipped the ends, just tie it on and just let it hang. Right lads, so I've started adding the strips that have been cut, and basically that's all you do, you just add it and add it and add it and keep adding it on. There's a bit of scrim scarf, anything you can get a hat of that's green and whatever. I like the reds because sometimes, especially around autumn time, you can spring some reds off, berries off the trees and that sort of stuff. So it just adds a bit of extra to it. So I'm just going to keep adding, and I'll come back when I've got them all added on and show you what it's like. Right guys, there's another essential bit of kit when doing ghillie suits. Got to happen. Right guys, I think I'm just about there now. So, don't bother with my legs because it's just a jacket you need, really, a little ghillie jacket, when you're lying down, just to break your shape up. Right lads, and this is the ghillie suit. Obviously you ignore the blue because you lay your combats on underneath it anyway. That's basically it. All of this just breaks up the shape and just proves they do work. Because I was sitting in the middle of a field the other day and a rabbit came out. Didn't even know it was there. Did after the pellet hit it, like, but you know.